There is no need to convince you that an SEO audit is important. You already know that, but it still gives you shivers sometimes, right? Today, I invite you to break the daunting SEO audit down so that it becomes a no-brainer. Hey everyone, this is Mary from SEO PowerSuite, the all-in-one toolkit that covers every aspect of SEO. Before we start, make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the next videos. And one more disclaimer. Since the topic of SEO auditing is quite extensive and includes a large number of steps, I decided to split it into two videos so that you can better observe the information and not feel overwhelmed. Let's start with the domain name audit as it determines your entire online presence. You need to make sure your audience can easily remember your website's address to find it later on. When choosing a domain name, you may have to buy an existing one. Before you make a purchase, make sure to check the history of that particular domain. It may turn out that this domain was involved in spammy activity, was penalized before, or had a bad reputation among users. And this may influence your future site rankings. To learn how this site looked before and what content it was delivering, use Internet Archive Wayback Machine. With its help, you can check if the site was full of spammy or, vice versa, quality content. Besides, you can use the Whois service to check out who was the previous owner of the domain. If several versions of your site coexist at the same time, make sure that users get access to only one of them. For example, there may be www and non-www versions, or HTTP, HTTPS versions. Each of these versions is considered a separate site, hence only one of them should be made a master version. Otherwise, search engines will index several sites, which in turn will cause duplicate content issues, and this may affect your website rankings. To see if that's the case on your website, check the redirects report in Website Auditor. For that, go to Site Structure, Site Audit, Redirects, and check out these two factors. If there are any issues, they will be marked with a red arrow icon. When you have an already established name in a niche, either big or small, that may be used by fraudsters. How? When users make a typo while typing your domain name, they may accidentally end up on an alternative website set up by some cybercriminals. As a result, your business may suffer losses due to traffic redirection. Besides, your reputation may be hurt if your name becomes associated with some malicious practices. To avoid such cases, you can simply monitor the site's typosquatting threats with the tools like DNS Twist and UpGuard. You can also register all the possible domain name variations and redirect them to the correct version. For example, if you type in linkassistant.com, you will end up on link-assistant.com anyway. If your site is larger than a couple of pages and is growing bigger, revising its structure once in a while becomes a must. Make sure that you organize the content on the site in such a way as to both satisfy users and search engines. Your task here is to check if the relationships between pages on the site are logical. Thus, make sure there are top-level pages, which are the most strategically important, large and target broad terms, and lower-level pages or categories supporting top-level pages that target more specific, long-tail keywords. Watch out your page's click depth. From search engine's perspective, the placement of pages on a site structure is a signal of importance. Thus, a page that is buried too deep in a site structure tree gets less weight. To check your important page's click depth, move to the Website Auditor's Pages report. Sort pages by organic traffic or any other important metric to find the top pages and check out their click depth. If you find a strategically important page with a click depth of 4 or more, consider reorganizing your site structure so that this page gets closer to the homepage. Let's move on. Internal linking. Internal linking is deeply connected to site structure and greatly depends on it. However, there are a few things you should consider besides it. Some case studies clearly show that the amount of links correlate with the traffic a page gets. Thus, the more internal links, the better. This rule is true to a certain point. When it starts to look unnatural or spammy, it's a no. Moreover, links stand out. If there are too many blue links or a colored button, the content looks a little bit stuffy. We've got enough visual noise already. On top of all, too many internal links coming from one page dilute its own link juice. That's why you need to check the following. Number of internal links from and to a page. Number of unique internal links per page. To do that, in Website Auditor, go to Site Structure, Pages. Here, check the Links to Page and Links from Page columns. We suggest to distribute internal links in such a way as to pass PageRank from the most weighty pages to the ones that don't rank that well. This way you will balance the PageRank of your pages and improve the overall site rankings. Now let's check anchor texts. John Miller says anchor text is important for ranking. So here's what you should do to make your anchor text work for your site. Ideally, your anchor text should be of different types. Check your links for random, generic, or naked anchor text because the usage of such should be minimized. Longer anchor text gives search engines more information about a page, so it potentially helps a link page rank higher. To find this information, go to Website Auditor, Site Structure, Pages, Links and Technical Factors. Click on any page and below you will find all its anchor texts. Broken links are hard to spot without a special audit, and there are a few reasons why they may appear. You misspelled the URL in the A tag. You changed the URL of a linked page. The page you linked to doesn't exist or was deleted. Returns 404 not found. To find broken links, find the corresponding column in the same pages report in Website Auditor. Finally, you need to find out if there are orphan pages on a site, the ones that are not linked to, because such pages may not appear in the Google Index. The easiest way is to quickly check it via the visualization tool in Website Auditor. They will be marked in gray. Navigation is also about internal linking. If set right, it allows users to easily find the needed content on your site. When you check the navigation on your site, pay attention to the following things. Navigation menus. Check if your header and footer are composed strategically. All selling pages should be placed in the header, and less important, though potentially useful links should be placed in the footer. Faceted navigation and pagination. If you run a big e-commerce website, you most likely have faceted navigation and pagination implemented. And it's so easy to foil your setup while doing it. Here, check URL canonical, no index tags, and robot.txt file. Breadcrumbs. You can implement any type of breadcrumbs, but make sure you do it correctly. Breadcrumbs should be located at the top of the page and its schema markup should be valid. Moreover, there shouldn't be breadcrumbs on the homepage, otherwise it's a link to itself. Your URL structure is mostly determined by your site structure. However, there are a few things you should watch out for. If the URLs are super long, they are not user-friendly, and this may result in poor user experience. Compare this URL and this one. You can check your lengthy URLs in Website Auditor's Site Audit Report. Find the URL section, Too Long URLs. If you see error or warning, think if you could shorten the URLs. Always choose the simplest URLs as possible, so that even if your page is located far from your homepage, its URL doesn't look like this. URLs that contain special symbols and different parameters are also considered neither user nor SEO friendly. They may be hard to perceive and can cause duplicate content issues. However, such URLs are inevitable if you have faceted navigation and pagination, or for example when you need to track session IDs and website traffic. To check your URLs for dynamic ones, go to Website Auditor's Site Audit Report and in the same URL section, find dynamic URLs. Again, if the issue urgently needs a fix, it will be marked as error. If it's an orange warning, consider tackling the issue in the near future too. Now let's check your content for issues that may be stopping you from reaching the top of the SERPs. The amount of content should be checked to spot the issues of thin content. This issue becomes real when you have too little content on a page, thus providing no value for users. To prevent that from happening, you first need to check the number of words on each page. In the same page's report of Website Auditor, check the word count column. To streamline the process, filter out pages with more than, say, 300 words. Then look through all the pages you just filtered and check content on each of them. Are these words enough to convey a message and help users? If yes, leave the page as it is. If not, consider updating it with more quality content. Sometimes content may underperform or its rankings may decline with time. You need to regularly check your site for such low-hanging fruits and optimize these pages so that the resources aren't wasted in vain. You can find such pages in Google Search Console. Go to the Performance Report, Pages, click on the filter icon, and set Positions, greater than 11. Thus, you will find pages that don't perform well enough to appear on the first SERP. Once detected, make sure to optimize this content further, elaborate on the topic more, add some keywords, revise technical SEO aspects such as meta titles and descriptions, header tags, and etc. To dive deeper into the topic, read our guide for full website content audit. I will leave a link to it in the description below. I believe there are a couple of topics your competitors have covered and you missed. We need to close the gap. To spot not yet covered topics, use Rank Tracker's Content Gap Analysis tool. Go to Keyword Research, Keyword Gap, and add your main competitors. You will get a list of keywords you should create and optimize your future content for. Some information tends to become irrelevant and untruthful, and not taking care of it may harm your reputation and rankings, as users are not likely to return to your website with outdated content. You can't actually find any automation tools here to spot such content. However, you may find all the articles that contain the past years in titles in Website Auditor using filters. Google's acronym WEAT stands for Experience, Expertise, Authoritativeness, and Trustworthiness, and now it is applied to every single query and search result, not just your money, your life sites. To send these WEAT signals to search engines, there should be specific content on your website, such as the author bio profile with social media links, contact us page, about us page, with the necessary information about the company. Moreover, make sure you don't mix your money, your life and non-your money, your life content. Google says it may confuse them when ranking a website. Unfortunately, there is no way to track WEAT issues automatically. But you can track your domain strength in Rank Tracker and compare it to your competitors. It will give you a rough estimation of how authoritative your site is for search engines. Pop-ups are important for marketing, plus there are pop-ups that you must put on your website like cookies consent. However, if they overlap the content and it becomes less accessible, a pop-up presence may result in a poor user experience. If they become intrusive, that may be noticed by search engines and your rankings may be lowered. Check the sizes of pop-ups so that they do not overlap much content, especially on mobile devices where screens are super small. You should additionally check your page experience report in Google Search Console to make sure that you optimized your pop-ups for web vitals correctly. Finally, there could be scraped content, also known as external duplicates. It happens sometimes that some disreputable sites steal your content and publish it under their names, and it's unlikely that Google will penalize them for scraped content. As a result, you will rank with this another page for the same keywords, and that's where you may feel the consequences. To check your site's content for external duplicates, you can use services like Copyscape. If you find out that your content has been stolen, contact the intruders with your cease and desist request. Now it's time for images. Images are just as important as text in terms of content, for e-commerce sometimes even more. And they are not less important than text. They are more visible and technically they are the largest part of a page. Now I will walk you through the most important aspects of image optimization. But if you want to learn all the details, check our step-by-step guide. I will leave a link to it in the description below. You need to make sure your images are in the correct format. As for the image size, I would like to say the less is better, but it's not quite true. You should opt for the lesser size until it damages the quality of the image and the objects in it become not distinguishable. You can compress your images before uploading them to your site. Most image compressors will let you significantly reduce the size of images without compromising their quality. You can quickly check the format and size of your images in Website Auditor. Go to Site Structure, All Resources, Images, and quickly scan the list. Use filters to speed up the search for under-optimized images. Just like with the URL structure, the image file structure is no less important. First, the image name and its URL path help search engines understand what the image is about. Second, images' names are a part of the user experience. When they save any of your image, it's great if they are correctly named and not confusing. Compare these two examples. However, don't rush to change your image file names if you spot some not very optimized URLs. Google claims it may take a few months for them to crawl new image URLs since they crawl images not as often as pages. You don't have to tune hundreds of images already uploaded to your site. Just follow image SEO best practices in the future. The next important thing is alt text.
Alt text also tells search engines what your image is about. In fact, it's even a more stronger signal than the image name or file structure. So you should check the pages for empty or poorly written alt text.
You can check all your site's alt text in Website Auditor. Site structure, site audit, images, empty alt text. An image is considered broken if it returns a 400 or 500 status code. The image URL is not specified in the image tag. Its URL leads to non-image content if there is a DNS error detected. In these cases, users see such images as follows. To detect broken images on the site, move to the Broken Images factor.
Backlinks are one of the most important ranking factors. It makes up your site authority and directly affects your site rankings.
First, you need to check the overall number of your backlinks and track the progress you've made over time. Quickly check that out in SEO Spyglass. Backlink profile, summary. It's also worth comparing your figures to your competitions. It will give you an understanding of your place in a competitive landscape. To get that done, in SEO Spyglass, go to Domain Comparison, Summary.
The quality of backlinks play a significant role in SEO. If you get low-quality backlinks, this may do more harm than good.
That's why you need to check how authoritative the sites linking to you are. First, open SEO Spyglass and go to Backlink Profile, Backlinks. There, check both the domain in-link rank and the in-link rank of a specific page linking to your website. If you see too many links marked in red, consider disavowing them in order to avoid Google penalties. Additionally, check the penalty risk each link in domain and page brings up. For that, go to Backlink Profile, Penalty Risk. There might be a number of reasons why a site page presents a high penalty risk. You can see the exact reason by clicking the info icon near each penalty score.
Anchor texts are also a signal of relevance. They provide more context to search engines and users and tell them what a linked page is about. And that's why it is important to keep track on your anchor texts. The matter is that if there are too many irrelevant or too many generic anchor text, it may look like spam activity. Such links may be considered low quality and won't bring your site any good.
Check your domain's anchor text in SEO Spyglass, Backlink Profile, Anchor Texts.
From time to time, check your backlinks growth for unusual spikes. A rapid growth of backlinks may indicate that your site has undergone a negative SEO attack. For example, your competitors can set a bunch of spam links on you to lower you in search results. Of course, it won't necessarily work out for them because Google may simply ignore such spam links. But it would be better to periodically check that out.
For that, go to SEO Spyglass, Historical Data. First, find backlinks, set the needed data range, and see how your backlinks grew. You may notice unusual spikes with a day's precision.
And that's it for today. That was the first part of the full SEO audit guide, and the second part is on the way. If you watched this video till the end, thank you so much. I hope you guys found it helpful, and if you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. See you next video. Goodbye.